Now let's begin, inshallah ta'ala, with a little bit of a discussion on the wording of the surah from the beginning. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. This is one of the few surahs of the Qur'an that begin with a commandment. You know the narration, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam is by himself in the cave of Hira, he sees this incredible light, and it's Jibreel alayhi salam, he grabs him, and he feels like he's going to be crushed, and he's commanded, اقرأ, and he responds, ما أنا بقارئ, I can't read, I don't know how to read. I am not one to read at all. Then he releases him, grabs him again and says, اقرأ. And again he responds, I'm not capable of reading. And then the third time, and there are two narrations of this. One of them is, he said, you know, the Messenger, or Jibreel alayhi salam recited the first few ayat. In another narration, the Messenger says, فَمَاذَا أَقْرَأ? What should I read? So he finally, you know, he caved in and said, what should I read? And then the messenger Jibreel alayhi salam recited these ayat, اقرا بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الانسان من علق اقرا وربك الاكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الانسان ما لم يعلم. Profound first revelation of Quran. And when this revelation was given, as I told you already, the messenger was horrified, he was terrified, and he in another narration says, كانه مكتوب على قلبي. It was as though it was written on my heart. I felt as though the revelation that was given was written on my heart. So anyway, he rushes back, he asks that a blanket be put over him, he fears for his life, and all of this, you know, the narration goes forward. But now let's look at the language itself. What did Allah choose to say to His Messenger? What were the first words chosen? To be this Qur'an that we have in our possession, how was it introduced to human beings? This is the introduction of Qur'an to human beings. Iqra, number one, read. The first commandment in the Qur'an. The first message given to humanity, read. Read. But reading alone, you know, reading has always been part of every intellectual civilization, right? But who is this messenger? An-Nabi al-Ummi, he doesn't even read. This command was not given to a society full of libraries and universities, a society that has a history of books and authors. Nothing. Even their literature is poetry. And even their poetry is barely written, it's just memorized. There's not even, you go to the library and find Arabic poetry, it's written in the Islamic era. It wasn't even written much before then, subhanAllah. And in this society, Allah Azza wa Jal gives the commandment of reading. Not only is the Messenger himself ummi, the vast majority of people in that society were not read. They were not read. And this is part of the miracle of the Qur'an. In response to that command, the Muslims became the most educated civilization in history. The mass education, the way it spread in the Muslim Ummah is unlike any other. We developed the modern university system as it exists. The PhD system in the Western world, if you trace its history, it came from the ijazah system in Islam. So higher academics and reading and research, as we know it today, is actually rooted in Islamic civilization, subhanAllah. These people that didn't even read themselves became the world leaders in reading. And this book that Allah gave, not even in the form of a book. You know, Quran was not revealed as a book. It was revealed in the form of just words, oral tradition. This orally related book became the mother of more books than any other in history. This one Qur'an is one book, but it gave birth to entire libraries across continents. So many tafsir, every book of fiqh, every book of aqidah, every book of history, in Islamic history, every book of tafsir, how many thousands upon thousands upon thousands of people, generation after generation after generation, have written and read and written and read, all coming from what source book? From Qur'an, subhanAllah. It's just one little word, and how it changed the world. How it changed the entire world around. It's a...